Welcome to the Good News Radio broadcast. Hello, this is Brenda Harris greeting you in the precious name of Jesus. Before Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. Now that we are going through recounts for our votes in the election because of voter fraud, there are many Christian leaders that have abandoned Trump. They say, "Oh, I am neutral." Well, in my opinion, this is very shameful. I guess they don't realize that we are fighting for our republic, we are fighting for our democracy, and we are fighting for our very way of life. Joe Biden is a globalist. Communism would be the law of our land very quickly if Biden got into office. Communism means that we would not be able to have rights of our own. You may think this is too fantastic of an opinion, but I'm telling you that this is what is on the agenda of the left. Biden said in one of his speeches that he doesn't need our votes, that they have created the most pervasive voter fraud machine. He said that he would need our support later on. Then, after his president-elect speech in which he called for unity, he said at the end of the speech, "The ones who do not support him should be on a list." Now that sounds very unifying, doesn't it? We are in a fight for our very way of life. In the book of Ecclesiastes, it tells us that there is a time for peace and there's a time to fight. I am fighting in the way that I know how to do, and that is speaking on this radio program and telling others that I come in contact with. Many Christian leaders have stopped supporting President Trump. I have never seen a more feckless pack of people in my life. Trump needs strong people to stand up for the rights of the people. We need strong people in our Christian world that are not cowards. We have the most pro-Christian president in our modern history. President Trump is pro-life and he's pro-Israel. But some of the Christian leaders say, "I don't like his tweets." Some of the Christian people say, "I don't like what he says. I didn't like Trump in the very beginning. I can relate. But I soon realized that Trump is God's man." Trump is like Cyrus in the Bible, who was used by God to save Israel. Cyrus was not a godly man, but God referred to Cyrus as his servant. Some Christian leaders are saying, "Well, I'm neutral." To me, that means they don't have the guts to stand up and be faithful. They were for Trump as long as it seemed like he was the one in power. Now, when it looks like he has lost, then they turn and run. We don't need men like that who are wishy-washy. Imagine how it would be if we had a God like that, a God that would be neutral. God is not neutral. God is not lukewarm. God is passionate and cares deeply. Trump is God's man. God chose Trump. You may not choose to believe that, but it's true, and I think you will see it eventually. And I believe with all my heart that Trump will win this re-election. And Trump, with God's mighty hand helping him, will bring about great justice and righteousness in this nation for the next 4 years. He will clean out the corruption in our nation. I heard a prophet many years ago say that Trump would clean out the corruption in our nation by the almighty hand of God, that was God's intent. Trump won by a huge landslide when you take away all of the illegal votes. There are about 2.7 million illegal votes in this election. The Dominion software that was used in many states flipped Trump votes to Biden. Now, I find it very interesting that the Dominion voting software had Chinese parts in it. This is Trump's hour of need. Have you ever heard of a fair weather friend? I'm praying that God will raise up men and women with a backbone. People who will stand up for this country and what is right. People who will stand up for Trump. I tell you what, I saw an 80-something elderly lady stand up for Trump. She had no fear. I was very proud of her. I'll bet you can guess who that is. I think God will expose the corruption in our nation. I really believe that it will all come to light. I understand that some people don't want to put their reputation on the line. They don't want to speak up. There's no risk that way. They want to take the comfortable way out. They say it doesn't matter who wins because God is still on the throne. And so we're just going to be neutral. I'm here to say it does matter who wins. God is always going to be on the throne no matter what. But God gives us choices. If you could talk to people in Germany before the Nazis took over, many would probably say we should have spoken up when we had the chance. And you may say it's not that critical, but I'm telling you it is that critical. You've seen what the left has been doing with all those riots, and the left is behind it. The same tactics have taken place that took place in Nazi Germany. They started out using riots to frighten people. If you'll examine the Antifa flag logo, it looks similar to that of the Nazis. Just think about it. Isn't there another word for neutral? How about lukewarm? Don't be lukewarm. Don't be weak. Would you be weak if someone tried to break into your house and harm your family? No, you would stand up for your family because you love your family. If you don't stand up for your country, eventually the bad policies will be on your own front doorstep, and then it will be too late. We are fighting for our freedom of religion. We are fighting for the republic. To be neutral at this time is to be lukewarm. I can't imagine God being neutral with us. How would you feel if you prayed to God in desperation and he said, "Oh, I'm neutral. I can't help you." No, there are times to take sides, and this time is one of them. The book of Ecclesiastes tells us there is a time for peace and there's a time to fight. There's a time to stand up for what is right. I look at David fighting Goliath. Goliath came against the God of Israel. Goliath lost. I think that is what will take place in our situation today. I think that Trump will be vindicated. I know that God is on Trump's side because Trump stands up for the unborn. Biden does not stand up for the unborn. Quite the opposite. As for me and my family, we are not neutral. And now, this concludes the message today. Again, this is Brenda Harris blessing you in Christ's name. May God's face shine upon you and show you his great favor.